Okay, good day everyone. This is Professor Roger Flores of the Department of Electrical Engineering, Central Mindanao University. The professor of this subject, EE86, the high-rise building design. Definitely for this subject, this is for the to discuss the how you are going to design electrical plan and electrical system for a high-rise building. So the chapter one of our subject is this electrical system design for high-rise building. Here you are going to discuss some insights, ideas on how you are going to design the high-rise building, no? So talking about high-rise building, we have different types of high-rise building. You have the complex building, or commercial complex, or residential condominiums, or even high skyscraper, or a combination of commercial and residential building. Okay, so to start with, let us discuss this chapter one. It is entitled Electrical System Design for High-Rise Building. Okay, so this is just the insight of the insight of our subject, no? To give us some insights in designing electrical system for this high-rise building. Okay, so as an introduction, high-rise building normally refer to occupancy for general offices. So more or less, most of the time, high-rise building is used for general offices or commercial establishments. Okay. So, and also another high-rise building is, as I've said a while ago, this is hotels, condominiums, or combination of these hotels and condominiums, or offices and commercial establishments. Okay, so depende sa inyo kung anong klaseng high-rise building. The definitions as to number of floors and areas vary from one party to another. So in other words, it depends, no? But just to give you in advance idea that what you are going to design here to make an electrical system design, let us focus to a combination of the condominiums, commercial establishments, and offices, no? So then car parks, okay? So yun pong i-design natin. And just to give you in advance, that to give you an idea in advance, that we will have to design not less than 20-story building or high-rise, no? Building, 20-story or stories, okay? This building distinctively differ from industrial buildings for manufacturing with regards to electric utilization. Of course, equipment installed and the number of floors, okay, the latter are mostly single or two-story. So in other words, this manufacturing or industrial building are most of the time constructed in a single story only. Okay, so that is for manufacturing, no? So to operational requirements and constraints, no? So yung operational arrangements, flow of work, processes yung sa manufacturing and industrial. So yun po ang dahilan bakit we have only at least a single floor only. Exceptions are to taller silos for stockpiling of materials or finished products. So maybe you are, if you are not so familiar with that silos, no, that is used to lift up the material, no, pagpa ipataas yung material sa taas, no, ipadala yung material sa taas, then gravitationally fold down, no, fold down. Okay, so that is a silo. That is different from this kind of installation. Okay, first thing that we are going to discuss here is the high-rise building power supply requirement. So ano po ba yung mga requirement na Kailangan nating i-design when it comes to power supply. So for this high-rise building, unang-una, we have this general lighting and power. Okay, general lighting and power. Okay, para sa ilaw natin at saka sa mga appliances, yung mga small appliance only, no? Light for general illumination, seeing tasks, decorative features, hallways, stairways, and others. So, kailangan mayroon tayong sinasabi natin na specifications. Gaano ba ka lakas ang ilaw ng hallways natin? Yung mga halimbawa mga stores, mga stool ng mga stores natin sa commercial complex, no? Halimbawa sa mga recreational establishments or areas, gaano ba ka lakas yung ilaw na gagamitin natin. So intensity of light is to be designed here. Power for the appliances, no? So we have here, we should have to consider the power source or power requirements for these appliances and office machines, no? Okay, number two, let's try to design also the heating, ventilation, and air conditioning system. This is very important because presently, we cannot live without ventilation and other air conditioning system. Kasi masyadong mainit na, grabe na yung global heating, no? So, halimbawa sa hotel or condominiums, you should have to design a water heater, for example, no? Or ventilations and air conditioning, or yun po ang sinabi natin na HVAC or HVAC, no? So, air conditioning for temperature control, then blowers of the fans ventilation, no? So, mayroong tayong mga establishments na kailangan natin na kahit fan na lang, no? Mga fan or fans, no? So, blowers and fans. Especially doon sa mga park areas, no? Doon sa ilalim, sa mga doon sa mga ano ba yan? Basements. Kasi hindi pwede na i-aircon mo yan kasi mayroon masupukit yung mga tao dyan. So, kailangan natin na mayroon tayong blowers. And this blower sometimes maintain the pressure, okay, below, no? So, we have this number three, transport system. Okay, ano ba yung mga transport system? Yung mga elevators, escalators, yung mga conveyors, no? Dump waiters, others, no? And others. So, yun ang mga transport system na kailangan natin ng power supply. So, alam ko, what is elevator, no? And escalators also. So, conveyors, so, this is, some of the conveyors are belted, no? Belted types. And dumbwaiters, so, this dumbwaiter is something like, it is also an elevator, but it is not used to transport passengers, no? Hindi mag-transport ng mga tao. Pero ang ginagamit po ito sa pag-transport from the lowest part to the highest story or floor. And ginagamit po ito sa mga sa supply, mga logistics ng building natin. So, yan nga tinatawag na dump waiters. Okay, so hindi yan siraulo ng mga waitress at mga waiter. Ha? So, yan po ang ginagamit na pang-transport. Halimbawa, office supplies or kitchen supplies, yan po ang ginagamit nila na transportation system, dump waiters. So we have to design also the water pumps, no? So we have these water pumps. It is either for potable or drinking water, no? Potable water or for drinking, and non-potable for washing only, no? So kailangan natin ng water pumps. We have to design the rating of that water pumps. Water sprinkle, especially for fire suppression, for fire system alarms, or for fire systems, not alarms, but for fire systems, especially for, of course, to protect, no, against fire, okay? Pumps and drainage, no? Especially if our building will have its basement, So we have this pump to pump waters going outside, because usually our basement is below the surface level. Then we have also sewage ejectors. Okay, so yung sa mga drainage natin, mayroon tayong mga limbawa natin na mga septic tanks, no? So another water treatment facilities, then we have to inject, or we have to remove that, and we have to pump that water from the tank. So we need to have these sewage ejectors. Okay, so and communication system also, we have to decide. So communication systems like PBX telephone system, intercom, no? So kailangan natin na i-design, kasama na yon sa electrical system design, yung sa communication system. Yung halimbawa, yung sa cable TV, communication, yung telephone lines, and telephone cables, no? So kasama na yon doon sa communication system, sa yung sa PBX telephone system, tsaka sa intercom. So we should have to consider that one also. Then number 6, we have this automatic doors. Okay, so alam nyo na, so mga hotels saka sa mga condominiums, halimbawa dito sa Bukid noon, mayroon tayong gaisano na mayroon tayong mga automatic doors. Okay, sa hotel kaya, sa ano ba yan, sa Susana, no? Diyan sa Susana, mayroon tayong mga building na gumamit na ng mga automatic doors. So we need to put the supply, or it has a power supply, no? To activate these automatic doors. This is for entrance and exit, no? For pedestrian, and even garage and freight, no? Then also we have to design also the central computer system. Of course, this time we are now using those system that are basically using computer for the processing of the information, no? So you have computer, halimbawa yung sa CCTV, dumaan na yan sa computer system. Or halimbawa sa mga control sa lighting natin, or sa iba pa, no? Mayroon, kailangan natin ng computer system. So we need to consider in our design CPU, peripherals, and other terminals, no? And other auxiliaries, no? Another auxiliaries that we need to supply power, no? Electrical energy. So intrusion and hold up control system, this is for like for example yung sa mga sensors, no, na baka mayroong outsiders na papasok doon sa building natin. So mayroon tayong control system or services, yun, mga sensors, no? Fire suppression and alarm systems. Okay, so kailangan natin ng power supply to power these sensors, no? Sound reinforcements and video facilities. Okay, so yung sa mga public address sound systems, no? Tsaka sa mga CCTV, okay? Then noise masking and acoustics and others. So we have several, no? Several things that we are going to consider in our design. Then we have a note here that the latter items could be integrated into the building automation system as may be provided in the design. So number 2, we have to discuss also high-rise building systems components. Ano po yung mga components na kailangan natin i-design? Okay, so we have here the high-rise building. The high-rise building electrical system is composed of hundreds of components, no? So it is understood, okay, designed and assembled into a safe, functional power components or power delivery system. Okay, so in the later page, no, of this slide, we have figure 2.1 shows a typical building electrical system riser diagram where the buildings is the building's electrical system is connected to the utility system. Ano po ba itong tinatawag natin na utility? Yun pong mga distribution utility. Basically, similar to Fibico, Boseco, si Palco, yun, ayun ang mga cooperatives, no? Mga electric cooperatives, yun ang tinatawag natin na distribution system. It is a pod-mounted transformer, okay? So, usually, most of the time, we are now doing a pod-mounted transformer. Hindi na yung transformer na ilalagay lang natin doon sa poste. Kailangan mayroon tayong separate base, no, para sa ating mga transformer. Kasi medyo malalaki na yung transformer natin na gagamitin, depende sa power requirement, okay? But in other cases, it might be a bank of transformers mounted overhead in a utility pole. Okay, so kung sabi ko po, yung kung maliliit lang yung power requirement, maliliit yung mga transformer na gagamitin. So, yun, pwede lang natin na doon natin ilagay sa mga poste. Okay, so for a demand less than 1,000 kVA, for example. But what if our power requirement is maybe up to mega na, yung mga 1,000 kVA na. So, or 10,000 or 100,000 kVA na. So, kailangan na natin ng medyo malalaki na mga transformer pad. The underground service connects the utility system. Okay? So, connects the utility systems to buildings main distribution panel or MDP. So, yun po. Pag mayroon kayong mabasa na MDP, yun po yung main distribution panel. Located within the MDP is the main building overcurrent service or main disconnect. Okay, yung gagamitin natin na disconnection na means, as well as individual overcurrent devices. So, when we see overcurrent devices, basically, mayroon tayong dalawang klase. We have the fuse or mayroon tayong mga breaker. So, mayroon na naman tayong mga high-rated breaker system. No? So, for the system component connected to the MDP or the main distribution panel, okay, may also contains provisions for utility metering. Okay, so mayroon tayong tinatawag na yung sa mga bago ngayon, yung sa mga utility, sa mga distribution utility, yung ginagawa nila, yun ang tinatawag natin na main, no? Yung sa mother meter yung ginagamit nila. Ayaw nila kasi yung individual metering. Ang sa kanila, yun ang mother meter, yung isa lang, no? Pinaka main meter. Okay, as well as the instrumentation for measurement of system voltage and current. So, ano po ba yung mga instrumentation devices? Unang-una, yung transformer. Mayroon tayong tinatawag na potential transformer. Ano po ba yung potential transformer? Potential itself is a voltage, no? So, step down the voltage so that the output voltage of that transformer will become measurable using the voltmeter, no? Or we have this CT or the current transformer. So step down the current to have its equivalent measurable current. Okay, so yun po ang tinatawag natin na instrumentation devices. Okay, so for that to measure the voltage and the current. Because otherwise, for example, we have this, halimbawa yung sa distribution natin, 13,800 volts. Wala naman tayong voltmeter na makamissure ng 13,800 volts. So, kailangan pa natin ng step-down transformer para at least more or less the voltage output of this kind of transformer is measurable, no? Or measurable. Okay, so to continue, the main disconnect device can be either a circuit breaker or a fuse. So that is what I have said. This main device after often contains a special circuitry for sensing low-level faults, no? Sensing low-level faults or ground faults for more than 1,000 ampere main, which otherwise might escape detection. Okay. So, it is normally located or the MDP might be thought of as the electrical nerve center of the building. Nerve center, siya po yung pinakasentro. Okay, so yun po ang tinitingnan natin yung MDP. It is normally located near building exterior wall and as and as close as possible to the utility transformer to minimize the cost of main service feeders. Okay, kasi alam niyo, pag malaki yung building natin, medyo malalaki din yung mga cabling na gagamitin natin for main feeder or main conductor. So pag malaki na yan, di mahal na yung gagamitin natin. So kailangan natin na yung MDP natin, doon natin ilagay or ilocate natin doon sa pinaka nearer to the distribution utility power supply. Okay. So, all components of the system must be chosen carefully based on design requirements and must function safely under normal operating condition and also under abnormal conditions such as short circuits. Okay. So, ito po yung sinasabi natin kanina. I do not know if you can still read this one, no? Ito po yung sinasabi natin na mayroon tayong typical electrical system riser diagram. So, bakit po ito tinatawag na riser diagram? Ito po yung ano natin. Ito po yung MDP, yung main distribution panel. Ito po, breaker, overcurrent protective devices. Dito po ito ilagay. Tsaka mayroon tayong tinatawag natin na vertical power supply system or busway. Okay? Ito po yung busway. Ano po yung busway? Doon po idadaan yung mga malalaking conductor, copper conductor. Kasi pag high-rise building, halimbawa more than 20-story building na, abot ng 100-story building or story stories, no? Or floors. So, ibig sabihin, hindi na tayo, ang mangyari dyan, hindi na tayo gagamit ng ordinaryong cable. Kasi pag cable pa rin yung gagamitin natin, ubos na lahat yung voltage. Kasi malaki na yung voltage drops going up. No? So, gagamitin natin dito yung mga bus bars na. Yung mga copper bus bars. No? Copper bus bars. So, doon natin yan ilagay sa tinatawag natin na vertical busway system. So, malalaki na, na yung bus bar na yan. So, siguro kung 3-phase o 3, no? Papunta doon sa taas. Okay. So, mayroon din tayong mga parang mga breakers, no? So, yung tinatawag natin na busway main breaker or switch. Okay? So, switch or main breaker, ito. Okay. So, ito po yung mga parang switch, no? That being connected from the busway. So, this is our busway, vertical busways. Okay. Dito nakalagay yung mga copper pero yung nakita namin sa no sa Cebu City yung sa pag field trip namin last time hindi copper yung ginagamit nila, aluminum, pero okay lang naman yun, no? So tatlong aluminum bus bar dito na dito dadaan sa vertical busways, no? So mayroon naka-connect dito na mga switches. Okay, so mga switch. So dito, ito po yung utility connection, no? Underground connection of the utility. Ito po yung transformer natin. Yun ang transformer that supplies the whole building. Ito po yung utility meter, check meter, mother meter, kung tatawagin ng mga layman's person sa mga utilities, no? So, mayroon din po tayong separate na power supply, no? Para sa mga sa air conditioning, sa iba pa, no, mga pumps. So iba pa rin yung mga iba rin ang connection nila, meron silang ibang connection. Okay, so pasok siya dito. So meron tayong grounding dito. Ito po yung panel board natin, feeder overcurrent, ito po box or panel boards natin, yung MDP pinaka main ito. Tsaka yung mga distribution na dito. Okay, so ito po yung para sa mga auxiliaries, no? So mayroon tayong power supply papunta auxiliaries. Ito po yung mga ano per level. Okay, so ibig sabihin mayroon tayong halimbawa ito po yung sa third floor, for example, sabi niya dito third floor, ito po second floor din ito, no? Ito pong first floor. So, dito sa first floor, dito nakalagay yung mga iba pang mga halimbawa yung sa generator natin. Okay? So emergency generator dito po nakalagay yung sa mga panel boards niya, yung sa automatic transfer switch. Okay? So mayroon po tayong tinatawag na automatic transfer switch dito or ATS. Okay, so dito po sa first floor or sa o di kaya sa basement to para mas safety, first floor natin ilagay yung sa generator natin, yung sa automatic transfer switch or sa ATS. Ano po ba itong ATS? Ito po yung automatic transfer switch. Transferring the power generated by the generator to the load or the power from the utility or galing po dito sa the power utility, no? Ito po. So we have other step down transformers here for the low voltage. Ito po ano ba tawag, indoor to, mga indoor na transformer to supply basic appliances now within the building. This is our second floor. This is our third floor, and so on and so forth. Okay, so on and so forth. So ito po yung tinatawag natin na typical building electrical system riser diagram. Kasi dito natin malalaman kung yung mga dinescribe natin na mga panel boards or mga loads, kung anong floor yan, no? Specifically, kung anong floor yan na malocate natin. So that is why I will say that this time you will be able to appreciate the use of this riser diagram. Okay, so this is an example of a riser diagram. Okay, so number three, we have to discuss the power supply system. Okay, so the franchise utility power company serves as a nominal level of 230 and 115 volts, single or three phase. No? So, two or three or four wires depending on the type of load, as long as it does not exceed the 1000 kVA. Okay, so mayroon tayong single phase lang, mayroon din tayong three phase, or mayroon tayong two wires for single phase, or mayroon tayong three wires for single phase also. Yun bang mayroong extra na conductor for grounding system? Okay, for three-phase system, apat yung wire natin. Ang pang-apat ay yung grounding system. Okay, that is very important, no? For extremely large service entrance current, multiple conductors may be used. Likewise, multiple protective disconnect or protective devices not exceeding 6 may be connected in parallel for the service entrance. Okay, so pwede din tayong mag-parallel ng protective devices, but kailangan hindi yan magsubra ng 6, no? So according to the Philippine Electrical Code, for establishments of greater than 1000 kVA, as most commercial and industrial consumers, the power company requires a load center unit substation. Okay, yun po, your substation might be outdoor or pwede rin yan na maging indoor, basta mga yung mga dry type transformers, pwede yan, mga indoor lang gagamitin natin, no? Yung ginagamit natin na dry type transformer, pwede yan sa indoor. So ibig sabihin, andun diyan sa we will locate that one in the undergrounds or below the building or within the building. I mean within the building. And serves power at primary line distribution level of 13.8 or 34.5. Depende yan sa available ng local distribution utility. The size of the load center depends on the proposed connected load and allowances for future growth of the establishments. Okay, so our load center rating or power, energy requirement, depende yan sa design natin. So unahin natin yung design bago tayo mag-specify ng load center or power supply or power requirements, no? On the other hand, depends on the requirements and available facilities of the utility company. Okay, so kailangan din natin ng coordination with the utility company, otherwise baka hindi nila pwedeng
hindi sila pwede mag-supply or mag-deliver ng specified voltage natin, baka hindi available sa kanila. So we have to coordinate, no? From the beginning of the construction, from the beginning of our design, we should have to coordinate with the local utilities. Okay, so the major components of the load center are the following. Number one, high voltage switchgears, no? So we have this high voltage switchgears primary side, power transformer section, load voltage switchgears secondary side, and then metering equipment. Yun ang pinaka-importante doon sa load center side. Okay, so we have this utilizing voltage. So ano po ba yung voltage utilization natin? Usually in large installation with private load centers, the practice is used to 208 by 120 volt. Yun ang common, no, na utilization voltage for general lighting and power, or 460 volts, no, for motors, and this appears to be the more economical and practical arrangements. Okay, three-phase electric motors are normally dual voltage, 460 and 230 volts, and using the higher 460 volt rating. Okay, so rating will result in half as much as ampere draw. Hence, small wires, lower circuit breaker rating, and smaller starter unit. Okay, so yun ang specifications usually, no, for electric motors. For lighting and appliances, 460 volts can likewise be used, but availability of fixtures for such potential may be easily procured, no? So ito po, kailangan natin ng mga yung mga basic data lang, kasi baka hindi ito available, no? 265 volt ballast for fluorescents and convenient outlet with built-in unit transformer of 50 to 100 volt ampere, no? So ito po yung mga common ratings ng mga ng voltage at kuryente natin. Okay. So for total load of 100 kVA or less, so below below 1000 kVA, or the power supply is 208 to 120 or 230 by 110, okay? 115 volt only. In some cases, and for temporary construction power, the power company would serve 460, you know? But this is not common, okay? So for voltage for use of construction equipment, subject to the requirements, rules, and regulations, kasi hindi ito common, eh. Okay, so configuration of load centers. Yun, kanina, we are talking about load centers. So should the customer enterprise be required to provide its own load center unit substation, several options are available again, no, subject to approval of the power utility company. Okay, ito po yung option 1, no, high voltage supply line from power company transformed to utilization voltage of 208 to 120 volt. Okay, for this is for general lighting and power, and 460 volt for motors using two separate transformer as shown in the figure. Two separate transformer, dalawang yung transformer natin dito, okay? So we have this transformer and we have the other one transformer. Okay, so ito po ay these two transformer will supply separate load, okay? So, ito po yung high voltage switchgear natin. Mayroon tayong primary means, yung disconnecting means, this is the incoming high voltage line. Okay, so mayroon din tayong interrupter switch dito bago sa transformers, no? Mayroon tayo dito. Okay, so mayroon tayong primary metering here. Okay, so mayroon tayong secondary metering, depende sa utility, no? So, secondary means after the transformer, after the primary and secondary metering. Okay, but as I have said, usually our local power utility here is using a primary metering system. Okay, so this is the bus bar that will distribute the power towards our load, no? So we have this bus bar. It is 208 to 120 bus voltage. And then 460 for this is for special for the motors. Okay, so this is for general lighting and power system. Okay, so ito pong tinatawag, itong area dito sa baba, ito po yung tinatawag natin na low voltage switchgear section. Okay, ito po yung presentations for option 1 if we will be using two separate transformer. Mayroon din tayong mayroon tayong isa lang, no, transformer. So ito po, high voltage supply line from power company transform to 460 general lighting and power feed by the 460 volt line and through unity dry type transformer 460 to 108 120 volts as shown this figure. So let us examine this one. Mayroon tayong high voltage line, mayroon tayong primary mains, disconnecting mains, mayroon tayong interrupter switch, tsaka mayroon tayong power transformer, medyo malalaki ito. So siguro mga 3-phase transformer or yes, of course, malaki na transformer. Mayroon din tayong secondary disconnecting mains. So distribute tayo, no? Distribute tayo sa mga motors natin using 460 volts. Tsaka pwede rin natin na from this voltage output of the transformer, pwede tayo, papunta na tayo sa yung tinatawag natin na lighting transformer type or unit. Ito po yung dry type na pang-indoor na transformer, no? So mayroon din tayong disconnecting mains. We have this bus of the specified voltage of 208 to 120 bus voltage. We have this feeder for general lighting and power supply of this small appliance. So ito po yung tinatawag natin na single transformer load center. Kasi po ito main power transformer ito. So ito lang po yung sa localized for general lighting and power of the appliances, no, system. So isa lang po yung transformer na ginagamit natin. Okay, so option 3 similar to option 2. Isa lang yung transformer but several units of smaller units of small dry type transformers are distributed, no? So mayroon po tayo dito. So feed by 460 line of or lines from the load center as shown in this figure. So start tayo dito. We have the high voltage line, incoming line, primary disconnecting mains, we have this interrupter switch, we have the power transformer. Then dito mayroon tayong secondary disconnecting mains. Dito na po tayo sa may bus bar. Ang bus bar natin is 460 volt bus connected to our load motor load. Okay, so ito po, mayroon tayong mga motor loads dito. Tsaka mayroon tayong mga linya na iba't ibang linya papunta doon sa mga loads natin, no? Ito pong letter T dito, ito po yung dry type transformer for general lighting and power. So ibig sabihin, halimbawa if this is our riser diagram, then per transformer here siguro iba't ibang floor ito, no? Iba't ibang floor na binigyan ng distribution or supply na energy, ng electrical energy. So marami tayong dry type po, internal dry type transformer for lighting and powers, no, or power supply or for the appliance. So this is another type of or option of this power supply or load centers. So let's continue. Okay, any of this configuration will serve the purpose of transforming the economic the incoming high voltage line from the utility to acceptable utilization equipment level. So the final choice of the desired system is normally dictated by cost and equipment availability. So yun po, economy is yung unang-una, tsaka yung equipment availability, supply ng mga transformers at iba pang mga yung mga disconnecting mains and iba pang mga devices, no. Power transformers are either dry type or oil immersed, no. Okay, so the common disadvantage of all the above load center configuration is its inflexibility in cases of breakdown of any of the main components. Okay, high or low voltage switchgear mains on the transformer itself will result sa total system shutdown. Pag mayroong mangyari doon sa pinaka-main na transformer, power transformer natin, so blackout lahat yung inside the building, no? Pero yun ang problema. So sa tinatawag ng ganyang mga options na nasa mga load centers system natin. Okay, so load center flexibility and reliability, ayun. Mayroon tayong could be adapted due to its prohibitive costs, no? So still some degree of flexibility and reliability of the system can be reasonably reached. Okay, the load center can be split into two equal or identical systems. Yun na lang pong load center ang i-split out, no? Kasi baka maraming kinakailangan na transformers, so para we have to limit, no, especially the economical reason, then we have to split yung load centers natin. So damihan natin ang mga load centers, no? So as far as practicable, no, divided electrical loads. Okay, so remaining half is still operational system, especially kung mayroon tayong masisira dyan sa loob, yung isa, so mayroon pa tayong reserva na isa, no? Okay, system selectivity can be attained either in the primary or secondary sides or both. Yun ba, mayroon tayong tinatawag dito na tiebreaker, no? So mayroon tayong tiebreaker. So properly coordinated interlocking systems could be provided. Yun po ang tinatawag natin na tie main breakers, no? To prevent accidents. So mayroon tayong tie breaker. Okay, so okay, the load centers described in the preceding paragraphs will be served on two separate ends, and thus term double ended unit. Meron tayong tinatawag na double ended unit. The power company serves this type of load center from two separate distribution feeder. So separate yung more than two or more, no? Loads distribution feeder yung supply natin. Okay, so this figure 3.3 shows the single line diagram of a typical double-ended systems adapted from option 3. Same can be done for both option 1 and option 2. So, kung titignan natin dito, ito po yung double-ended load centers, no? Mayroon tayong dalawang incoming high voltage line. Okay, so mayroon tayong primary means, nilagyan natin ng interlocking dito. Sa yun ng tinatawag natin na tie circuit breakering breaker, no? Ito po yung mag-interlock para hindi mag-short circuit itong dalawa. Okay, so kasi halimbawa ngayon pag masira ito yung primary mains natin, pag masira ito, pwede dito tayo kukuha, dito siya dadaan. Okay, dito sa tie circuit breaker dito siya dadaan, pwede rin pa rin natin masupplyan dito. Or pwede din dito sa baba, no, sa secondary side. Dito pwede na rin dito yung tie circuit breaker dito. Okay, so mayroon din tayong dalawang interrupter switch, power transformers, and then mayroon tayong secondary mains here, and then we have this tie circuit breaker, as I've said, no? Baka dito ang sira, dito sa power transformers yung sira natin. O di kaya hindi magpa-function itong secondary mains. So dadaan dito yung power natin, yung energy natin, dadaan dito sa tie circuit breaker. Okay, so tie circuit breaker dito siya dadaan pag sira ito, no? So at the same time, mayroon pa rin tayong power supply dito. So halimbawa, normal yung operation dito sa kabilang linya, dito siya dadaan. Halimbawa, ito pong nasira yung power transformer natin dito. Okay, so ito pong tinatawag natin na double-ended load centers. Dalawa yung load centers natin. Ginagamitan lang natin ng tie load breakers. Okay, the interlock mechanical or either mechanical or electrical will prevent putting on the tie breaker until either of the main breaker is off. Okay, so klaro yan, no? Metering CTs and PTs are to be installed in both the high voltage and incoming line, so line 1 and line 2. Okay, so kailangan din natin ng these metering devices like current transformers and potential transformers. Okay, so yun po ang lahat-lahat na discussion natin dito. So sana po marami tayong we understood many things, we understand many things, and we learned many things. So if you learn many things, if you think that you learn many things, just try to subscribe my YouTube channel and try to share and click that notification bell so that whenever I have a new video uploaded here, then you will be able to be you will be notified. Okay, once again, thank you very much. God bless and stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you very much.